Pleasure is mine to welcome our today's resource person, Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan, Chief Strategic and Outreach Officer at the National Digital Library of India, South Delhi. Let me take privilege of sharing the information about resource person of today's session that I came across. Dr. Vignesh Swarnamohan is currently the Chief Strategic and Outreach Officer, National Digital Library of India. He is also the founder of Berlin IAS Preparer, a mobile-based low-cost training solution for the civil service aspirants. Earlier to this, he worked with the Indian Public Library Movement and the CSE e-govern Service India Limited. He has more than 14 years of research, development, and program management experience in the domains of information and communication technology for development, education, skill development, e-governance, leadership, public policy, health, and rural development. He has managed large development projects like National iDigital Literacy Mission, Cybergram Yojana, e-inclusion, IT training for rural SC/ST women beneficiaries, e-Vidya, innovative project for rural women, Women Digital Literacy Project, Child Labor Family Linkage Project, Financial Literacy and Investor Awareness, Legal Literacy, Digital Diagnostic Kit and Telemedicine Centers. He also conceived and implemented many innovative ICT policy initiatives for promoting inclusive growth in rural parts of India. He holds a Doctor of Philosophy from the Center for the Study of Law and Governance, Jawaharlal Nehru University.
Kasalingam, hello, sir. Dr. Kasalingam, kindly mute your mic. Dr. K. Kasalingam, kindly mute your mic. Okay, so thank you so much. I think so I again request everyone, kindly mute your mic throughout the entire webinar. Kindly do not turn on your mic or video, because suddenly somebody turns on the video and the mic. So this is the last time I'm requesting you, kindly do not turn on your audio, mic and the video. If you do it, then we might have to take you out from this webinar. So that's the only option we have left, because we have given sufficient time for you to follow these basic requirements. So I think without taking much more time, let's begin the webinar. So am I audible, and is the presentation visible? If yes, kindly put it in the chat message. Okay, so thank you, Nichita and Karthik. So good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dr. Vignesh. I'm part of the National Digital Library of India team, and look up to the outreach activities of the Digital Library Initiative of the Government of India. So let's see, what are we going to see in in today's webinar. So what today we're going to look at six things. One is, why NDLI? Who is this for? What kind of content we have at NDLI? How to access NDLI? What is the difference between Google and NDLI? And then how to operate NDLI club in your own institution. So this is what we are going to look at in today's webinar. So why NDLI? So before we get into why NDLI, let's have a perspective of why the perspective of NDLI. So if you have a look at this map of India, so this is this shows the literacy rate of India as per the 2011 census. So except very few states like Goa, Kerala, Tripura and Mizoram, where the literacy level is above 90%. But the majority of the states, if you look at the light pink colorish area, the states, their literacy level is below 75% as per the official statistics. And this is one fact that we have. On the other hand, there is another statistics which says every month at least 1 million people, that is 10 lakh students, are turning into age 18. That means they are getting in, they are eligible to get into the higher educational stream. So if India has to give access to higher education to these 1 million youth, they have to set up at least 270 colleges and 6 universities every month. So that requires a huge amount of financial and human resource impact. And so the government of India, and like setting up these institutions are easy, but sustaining the these institutions are the most difficult part. And so the government of India looked at various solutions which can address this requirement. So one of the solutions that they looked at is the digital solutions. You might have already heard of NPTEL, Swayam, Swayam Prabha, Gyan, NDLA. So all these are supplementary and complementary learning resource materials that the government of India has created for. So is my voice audible or is it very low? Is it okay?
Yes, sir. It is audible. Very clear, sir.
Okay. So thank you. I think maybe for some people, the internet may connection may be slow, so their audio may be less. So this is one aspect. So now let's look at why NDLA. Why this National Digital Library of India? So if you look at the last few years, say for 5 to 7 years, the budget for libraries, the budget and the human resource for the libraries has been drastically reduced. So except very few institutions where they have allotted a good amount of financial resources for libraries, in majority of the institutions the budget has been reduced and also the human resource have been reduced. So what does this implies? This means when you have reduced amount of budget for libraries, it means you have less you're going to acquire less number of quality knowledge resources, and which will in turn result in access to less number of quality knowledge resources, which will have impact on the learning outcomes. So it's all interlinked. So when the learning outcomes are less, then the livelihood opportunity for these people who complete their programs is also less. So it's all interlinked. So that's one aspect that the government looked at. And also, like wherever we have visited, so I might have visited around 500 to 600 institutions across the country. So be it an academic library, research library, or a public library. So one challenge that many of the librarians have told me is the physical infrastructure. Say for example, so you have a building for library and that has some limitations. You can't have, like, depending on the size of the infrastructure, you can't have more than say 10,000, 20,000, 1 lakh resources in the library. So they look for additional infrastructure buildings for hosting these resources, which many institutions finding it difficult to provide. In fact, in few institutions I've seen, the books which were purchased have not even been opened because they don't have space for stacking them. So I've seen, like, in the corridors of library, many books have been kept on the corridors without even being opened. And then in the physical library, we have a challenge of accessing same resource by multiple person at the same time. Say for example, if it's a quality knowledge resource and which is available, which maybe one or two copies may be available in the library, but maybe 100 people want to access this resources at the same time. So which requires, so that is a challenge in the physical library. And then you have cases of missing books, hidden books, damaged books in the library. That is also very prevalent in the physical libraries. And looking at all these challenges, the government of India wanted to actually democratize the education. So they wanted to provide quality knowledge resources to every Indian citizens. So with that objective, the government of India has created National Digital Library of India as a knowledge asset for the country. So which was, it was launched on in the year 2016 as a pilot project, and then which is dedicated to the nation on 19 June 2018 by the then MHRD Minister Sri Prakash Javadekar ji. So now let's look at what do we have at NDLA. At NDLA, we primarily store metadata, right? So metadata stands for data about data, or in this context, you can put it as basic information about a resource. Suppose if there is a book, who is the, what is the title of the book? Who is the author? Who is the publisher? What is the number of pages? What are the subject domains that is covering? And then abstract of the book. So this basic information about that book is called metadata. So at the NDLI, we only ingest and ingest metadata for search and browse facility only. We don't store any full text resources. So, and then you may ask me like, how will you give the access to the full text resources? So I will show you this small diagram which depicts how NDLA operates. So at the center, you imagine this is the NDLA portal, right? And suppose we have collaborated with say University of Lucknow. Okay, for example, we have collaborated with University of Lucknow comes and tells us that they have got some 1,000 non-copyrighted open source resources which they want to share it with every Indian citizens. Okay, so in that case, what we do is we help them in so they already digitized the resources. It's available in the PDF format or video format or audio format, whatever educational resource format. And then we help them in setting up an IDR. That is, IDR stands for Institutional Digital Repository. And we follow DSpace for our IDR. So our team sets up IDR, and then we give a metadata schema in which those 1,000 non-copyrighted open source resources have to be entered. Once they enter, they upload it in their IDR along with the full text in their server. The IDR lies in the University of Lucknow server. So now what NDLI does is only pulls the metadata from that IDR and then keeps it in the NDLI portal for search and browse facility only. Okay. Imagine, suppose if a researcher from, say, Namakkal wants to access a paper published by one of the faculties of University of Lucknow. So he comes to NDLI and then he searches for the resource from the NDLI repository. And suppose if this resource is available from University of Lucknow, we direct him to the IDR of University of Lucknow. So University of Lucknow validates his credentials. If it's coming from NDLI, then they will give access to direct access to the entire full text. If it's a full text resource, they will give it to the researcher from Namakkal. So this is how NDLI functions. So we don't store any full text. We only store the metadata. So there is a purpose for this model, because at this point in time, metadata is non-copyrighted, whereas the full text is copyrighted resource. Okay, suppose if a partner uploads a copyrighted material, then we may end up in a situation that we might have to close down NDLI for violating the copyrights. So we don't want to violate the copyrights of any author or publisher. So so this is how we operate. So we don't want to violate any copyrights. And then at NDLI, our partners host at least three different type of content for the users. First one is born digital object. So born digital object is, suppose if an author has created a article and then uploaded it in on the publisher's website using a PDF file. So now he has typed the entire article in his computer. He converted it into a PDF and gave it to the publisher. So now this is a born digital object. Imagine 30 years back when there was no computer for computer usage of for typing and all. So what might have happened is they might have handwritten or typewritten it. Now this resource is available in the physical format. In this case, we can what we can do is we can digitize the entire resource and convert it into a digital file, like a PDF file. So now this type of file is called digital surrogate of a physical object. And the third format we have is only the metadata. We only have the digital metadata of a physical object. So these are the three types of content that are available at NDLI. And NDLI doesn't store any full text resources. We don't store any content. We only ingest the metadata for search and browse, and the full text is delivered from the source itself. Okay. So as of today, we have partnered with closer to 278 content partners spread across the entire world. So there are all the major Indian educational research institutions are part of NDLI, and more than 50 publishers are part of NDLI. And so you can check them in our site, who are our content partners. So what type of content we have at NDLI? So computer science, information and general works, we have closer to 1 crore resources. Philosophy and psychology, 6.1 lakh resources. Religion, 2 lakh resources. Social sciences, 45 lakh resources. Language, 1 lakh resources. Natural sciences and mathematics, 83 lakh resources. Technology, 1 crore resources. The arts, fine and decorative arts, 4.5 lakh resources. Literature and rhetoric, 7.8 lakh resources. History and geography, 6.1 lakh resources. So in total, if you add all of these, we have 4.8 crore resources. And this is classified as per the DDC. DDC stands for Duo Decimal Classification. For people who are from the library science background, what know what DDC is. So for non-library science background, kindly go to Google and search what is DDC stands for. Okay. So I wanted to I forgot I should have told you. So for people who are attending this webinar, if you need a certificate of participation, then we will be circulating a quiz come feedback form towards the end of the webinar. And the quiz questions will be from this presentation only. So kindly listen to the presentation carefully, and then this will be helpful towards the end of the webinar for filing of the feedback form. So now let's look at the top 20 content contributors of NDLI. So World eBook Library is the major content contributor of NDLI. They have contributed closer to 77 lakh resources. CiteCRX, 52 lakh resources. PubMed Central, 38 lakh resources. IEEE Explore Digital Library, 33 lakh resources. WHO Global Index Medicus, 26 lakh resources. Springer Link, 21 lakh resources. So IEEE and Springer Link, we only have the metadata. We don't have the full text resources. Okay. And then what type of content? So I told you there are 4.8 crore resources, out of which it contains a range of content. So the content could be a thesis, PhD thesis, dissertation, projects, presentations, video lectures, audio lectures, class notes, term papers, assignments, assessments, solutions, question banks, e-books, articles, annual reports, law acts, law judgments, data sets, manuscripts. So you name any major form of educational resource, they're available at NDLI. And then access options. So there are five different types of access options available at NDLI. Okay. And those five access options are open So this is denoted, which means the full text is available to all. For example, NCERT is one of those open resources, and it's denoted by a green lock with open symbol. So that is open access. And the second one is NDL uses. So this is denoted by a man with the NDL written on the chest. So NDL users also gives full text available for all the users registered at NDLI. And then third one is limited access, which is say, for example, if there is a 50 page article, maybe only 20 page of the article may be available for the user, remaining 30 pages may not be maybe hidden. So that is the limited access. And subscribed is say, for example, IEEE or Springer, we only have metadata as of now. Suppose if your institution has subscribed to IEEE or Springer, then you can search it from NDLI itself. And then the moment you click on IEEE resources, it will check whether your IP has been already bound with IEEE or Springer. If it's already given access, then you can access these resources at free of cost. And then restricted. So this is only for their own internal consumption, this kind of resources. So these are the five different access options that are available at NDLI. And then access right-wise content, if you look at it, so we have 2.74 crore resources which are open resources. That means that is a full text resource. And similarly, 77.94 lakh resources are NDLI resources. So this is also full text resource. So if you combine these two, open and NDLI resources, we have 3.62 crore resources which are full text resources. So full text resources means you can actually download these resources and then use it for, you can download the entire book or article or audio or video. You can download it and use it for educational purposes at free of cost. You don't have to pay a single penny for using these resources. And then who is this for? So NDLE has content for every age group, starting from school going students to college going youths, professionals who are working, academicians, researchers, edupreneurs, lifelong learners. So we have resources for every age group. So now let's look at how to access NDLI. So go to accessing NDLI is very easy. Just go to Google or any search engine for that purpose, and then search for National Digital Library of India. Okay. And the first URL that you will get, which is ndl.iitkgp.ac.in, and it's National Digital Library of India. So you just click on this first URL. Once you click, it will take you to our home page. So this is how our home page looks like. Suppose if you want to search, so then what you need to do is, at the center we have the search box. So go here and then click here and then type the search keyword. Okay, so now I searched for a topic called Tamil literature. Okay, and then here I changed the language. So I have changed the language to Tamil. So you can actually change the entire NDLI interface into various Indian languages. And then this is available on the top. There is a language tab. Click there and then come to Tamil. I've chosen Tamil as the language interface, and the entire language interface has been changed into Tamil. Okay, so I searched for Tamil literature, and then in the language tab I chose only Tamil. So what I got is 2325 results on the topic of Tamil literature in Tamil language. Okay, and the next topic I searched was on history of English literature. Here, two things you need to remember before using NDLI. One is the search keyword. This is very important. The search keyword, that is the most important thing. So you have to enter the correct and the relevant search keyword without making any spelling mistake. Okay, if you make a spelling mistake, then the results will be different. So here I searched for the history of English literature. Okay, and then the second important thing you need to remember is the various filter options. Okay, so here I chose the subject category of language and literature and rhetoric. I got 6.74 lakh resources on the topic of history of English literature. And the next topic I searched was on modern India. So here I chose two filters. One is access restriction, NDLA and open, and the subject category history and geography. So I got 20,000 results on this topic of modern India. And the next topic I searched was on Indian constitution law. I wanted only full text resources. So what I did was I went to access restriction and I chose open and NDLA. I got 31 lakh resource on the topic of Indian constitutional law. So and the next topic I searched was on engineering mechanics. So here I wanted it from a specific author called Sudarshan Iyengar. So I went to author and chose Sudarshan Iyengar. I got 862 results on this topic of engineering mechanics. And the next topic I searched was on 1984, which is one of those top 10 novels in the world. And here there are two 1984s. Okay. And one, so there are three icons that below every search item. So the first one is whether it shows whether it's NDLA or open or subscribed or restricted. So this is the access option available here. And the second one denotes the language. Okay. Here, this shows HUN, which means it's a Hungarian language one. And here it's written as ENG, which means it's an English language content. So suppose if you want the English language content, just go here and then click, then you will get the English language content. And the next topic I searched was on sociology. Now I wanted only video lectures on this available on this topic of sociology. So what I did was, on the right hand side, there is a filter called content type and I chose videos. I got 455 results on this topic of sociology. And the next topic I searched was on biochemistry. Suppose I want only various theses available on this topic of biochemistry. So what I did was I went to source and then chose InfliBN and Shodhganga. I got 3,383 results on this topic of biochemistry. And the next topic was on microeconomics. So the sources Asim Premji. So what I did was I want the sources only from the content only from Asim Premji Foundation and the MIT Open Courseware. So I chose these two sources. I got 251 results on this topic of microeconomics. Similarly, human physiology. I wanted only video lectures. So I chose video here. I got 12,788 video lectures on this topic of human physiology. Next topic was artificial intelligence. So here I wanted it only from source of MIT Open Courseware. I got 64 results. And then Java programming. So I wanted it from the subject category of computer science and technology. Again, video lectures. I got 3,197 results on this topic of Java programming alone. So I told you about the home page. You saw a section called Study at Home, COVID-19 Research Repository, and then Featured Collections. So this has been created during this time of lockdown. Our team has actually classified the resources into various educational levels and domains. So there is so here you can see the contents are classified for schools. So if you want the contents relevant to school students, so just go here and click school. And then if you want content relevant to engineering disciplines, click here engineering and then science, humanities, literature, management and law. So depending on the subject of area of interest or study, you can choose the relevant tab. And then here next one is research repository on COVID-19. So our team has actually collated the various resources available on COVID-19 and then created a research repository. So suppose if I want to know the various contents available for engineering, so I just have to click on engineering. Once I click, this page will open. So it has various tabs. common subject, aerospace engineering, architecture, chemical engineering, civil engineering, computer science and engineering, electrical engineering, electronics and communication engineering, mechanical engineering, and then mining engineering. These are the various subject domains that we have. So now I am going to show you how to open a resource from NDLI. So I search for a topic called research methodology, and then I wanted it from the source of Lovely Professional University, right? So now if I want to open this first resource, what I need to do is just click. Once I click, this page will open. So there are two tabs on the top. One is content, another one is metadata. First you click on metadata. So metadata, as I mentioned, metadata is nothing but basic information about a resource, or in definition terms, it's data about data. So here, in this context, the metadata fields are the title of the resource, which is research methodology, sources from Lovely Professional University, content type text, publisher Excel Books Private Limited, file format PDF, language English, subject domain, subject keyword, educational role, learning resource type, and publisher date. So if you find this resource useful, then the second thing you need to notice is the access restriction. So suppose this is an open resource, which means you have access to the full text resources of this file. And the third thing you need to notice is whether you have logged in. So this you can see here, since I have logged in as Vignesh Swarnamohan already. Now, if I want to download, what I need to do is just go here and then click content. Since it's a full text resource, the entire 338 page content will get downloaded into your system. Whether you use a desktop, laptop, or mobile phone, depending on the device you use, the entire resource will come down to your system. Imagine, okay, so there is Mr. Ratho Namdev Krishna Rao. Kindly turn off your video, please. Dr. Ratho Namdev Krishna Rao, kindly turn off your video. Okay, so suppose you have not logged in. So on the top right corner, you can see it is asking for you to log in. Without logging in, if you click on this content, it will take you to this page and ask you to please log in to view this content. You have to log in to view this content. So in that case, what you need to do is just click on this login. Once you click on this login, this pop-up window will appear. Suppose if you remember your email ID and password, which we used for registration at NDLI, just enter the email ID and password and enter the captcha and then submit. Okay, then you will be able to now download the resource. Imagine you registered at NDLI a couple of years back, 2 years back you registered, but you forgot your password. You remember your email ID which you used, but you forgot your password. So in this case, what you need to do is click on this account recovery button, and then here enter your email ID and then submit. So once you click on submit, you will get a password reset email with the required information. So the required information, you have to just follow the process, and then you have to reset your password and then come back and enter your email ID and new password, enter the captcha, and then click login. So you will be able to download it. Suppose if you have never registered at NDLI, so this is the first time that you have heard about NDLI, or this is the first time you are going to use it, download a resource, then what you need to do is click on this icon called register. Once you click on this icon register, then this registration form will open. So the registration form contains some important information. The important details that you need to enter is your full name, your email ID, preferably personal email ID, and then your password and confirm password. So these are the four information that you have to provide. But these are mandatory details that you need to provide. Apart from this, you have other information like data birth, gender, your name of the institution, date of birth, and all these basic information. Fill these details and then submit. Once you submit, you will get a verification email. So click on the verification URL and then your account get activated. Then you can come back and enter your email ID and password and get started. So the entire registration process will not take more than 5 minutes. Okay, so one time registration, spend 5 minutes and then you are all set to use NDLI. Suppose if it's a video lecture, so this is how the video lecture will look like. So as I already mentioned, for using NDLI you need to remember two things. One is the search keyword without any spelling mistake, and the second thing is the various filter options that you need to know before narrowing the results. The first filter is access restriction. Suppose if you want only full text resources, choose open and NDLI. You will get only the full text resources from NDLI. And the second one is author. So you search for a topic and it lists what are the authors that are available. Suppose if you want resources from Xing Wang, so just go here and click Xing Wang, you will get the resources from this specific author. And the third filter option is subject category. So as I mentioned, this is the content is classified as per the Dewey Decimal classification. So here, depending on the search keyword, you can choose the subject category. Okay, and the fourth filter is file format. Suppose if you want only PDF files, go here and click on PDF. Suppose if you want MP3 files, come here and choose MP3 files. And suppose if you want MP4 files, just choose MP4 files. And the fifth filter option is language. Suppose if you want resources, so at NDLI, the resources are available in more than 300 national as well as international languages. Suppose if you want the resource from in Hindi, just go here and type Hindi. Suppose if you want the resource in Tamil, if the resource is available in this language of your choice, it will definitely come. Okay. And the sixth filter is learning resource type. Suppose if you want only audiobooks, come here and choose audiobooks. Suppose if you want newspaper clippings, just click here, newspaper, books. So there are about 60 different learning resource types that are available that you can narrow down using your search results. And the seventh filter option that we have is the source. So as I mentioned, there are 278 content contributors. So all those content contributors come under this source option only. Okay, so you can choose, say for example, suppose if you want the resources from Bloomsbury, so come here and choose Bloomsbury. Okay, suppose if you want the resources from Bharatiya University, come here and choose Bharatiya University. So, and the last important filter that I'm going to talk about is the content type. So this filter is available only in the desktop applications, and this filter is available on the right hand side of the desktop applications. Suppose if you want video lectures, just go here and choose video, then you will get only the video lectures. So I already told you NDLI interface, the portal interface can be changed into various Indian languages as of now, and currently it is available in Hindi, Bangla, Gujarati, Marathi, Tamil, Odia, Kannada, Assamese, Malayalam, okay, and other Indian languages are also under development. And for ease of use, our users, we have a mobile app, NDLI mobile app also, which is available in both Android as well as iOS. So the Android, suppose if you want to download an Android app, go to Play Store, Google Play Store, and then search for National Digital Library of India. And the first URL which you most likely get is the app which you will get, which should contain this logo of NDLI, National Digital Library of India, and the topic of the app, which is National Digital Library of India, and the app publisher is National Digital Library of India. So you have to check all the three. If it's relevant, then you go and install it in your mobile phone. So similarly for iOS, go to your iStore and then search for and National Digital Library of India app, and then you will see, you have to see the same three things: the logo, topic, app name, and the publisher. So if all the three seems to be okay, then you install the app. So now I'm going to show you how to use the NDLI Android app. So once you install the app, so you open the app by clicking it. So once you open, so the you see the first screen. This is how our home page of NDLI app looks like. So first home screen shows subject domain. It shows the various subject areas that is there. So for example, we have seen as per the DDC, we have classified the content. And the second one is learning resource type. Suppose if you want books, just choose books, question papers, articles. So you can actually scroll down to see the other learning resource types, and similarly subject domains, and also featured sources. Right? Suppose you want to search a topic. What you need to do is just go here and click on the search icon, which is available on the top. So once you click on this icon, you will get this search box. Right? So in the desktop application, the search box is by default available on the top, but in the mobile app, you need to click on this icon to open the search box and then enter the search keyword. So here I search for a keyword called Uttar Pradesh. Okay, and I got 41,573 results on this topic of Uttar Pradesh. Suppose if you want to narrow down using the filters, so in the desktop application, the filters are available on the left hand side and on the right hand side, but in the mobile app, the filters are available on the bottom right corner. So this orange color icon is the filter option in the mobile app. So you just click on this orange color icon. You click on this orange color icon, then all the filters which we saw on the desktop application will appear on the top. Okay, so you so here I can see three filters, so you can actually scroll down to see the remaining filters. So you can actually scroll down. Okay, so now what I did was I went to a filter called source, and then I wanted the resource only from Aligarh Muslim University, AMU. So I chose Aligarh Muslim University and then clicked apply. I got 199 results from this topic of Uttar Pradesh from Aligarh Muslim University. So this is how you need to use NDLI mobile app. So before we move further, I'm going to give you a small activity to all of you. So the activity is you have to install NDLI mobile app. So that's the first activity that you are going to do, and the second activity you are going to do is search for the topic of your interest or your subject of teaching or subject of study, and then let me know whether you found it useful or not. So once you've done this work, so go to the chat window and then enter whether you install the app. If you install the app dot I searched on. So Miss Manpreet Kaur, kindly turn off your video, please. Thank you. Suppose if you have searched on the topic of say artificial intelligence, then I searched for artificial intelligence and found so many results. Okay, and whether it is useful or not. So I want you to put it in the chat window. So I'm going to give you 5 minutes. It's 12:49 in my system. So we will do it till 12:55, so 6 minutes of time, and your time starts now. So as I mentioned, we are going to do two activities. First activity you're going to do is you're going to install the NDLI mobile app, and the second one is you're going to search in the app how to what are the topics of your interest or subject of study or subject of teaching, and tell me whether it is useful or not. Okay. So these two activities you are going to do in the next 5 minutes, and your time starts now. So during this 5 minutes, you can actually turn on your camera so that I can take few screenshots of the participants, only for 5 minutes. Okay, thank you. So but for people, if you're not comfortable in turning on the video, it's fine. Don't worry. No worries. And kindly mute your mic throughout the session, please. So now you can turn off your camera, Dr. Meban Daba Rabon, Gurpal Kaur, Abhishek Rana, P. Senthil. So kindly you can turn off your camera. So I want to know like the search topic which you found. So for example, Mr. P. Senthil searched on physiotherapy and found 19,600 results. Mr. Nadeem Isan, kindly turn off your camera, please. Ms. Gurpal Kaur, kindly turn off your camera, please. Mr. Neelappa Tatatri, kindly turn off your camera, please. So, Mr. Rajesh Sharma searched on biotechnology. Good. So, Charulata searched on cloud computing. Mr. Nadeem Isan, kindly turn off your camera. Ms. Gurpal Kaur, kindly turn off your camera. Okay, so our 5 minutes time is over. So suppose if you are, so we will give the URL for feedback, quiz come feedback form only towards the end of the webinar. So you have to wait for a few more minutes before we share it. So Ms. Urmila, kindly turn off your camera, please. So suppose if you found NDLI app useful, and if you find relevant resources for so Miss Urmila, kindly turn off your camera. So suppose if you're finding this resource useful, so a lot of people say that it's found useful and they are finding it, finding relevant resources for their subject of teaching or study. So my humble request to everyone is, if you are, if you see the value of NDLI, right, kindly share it with 100 people that you know. So you have been part of so many WhatsApp groups, and they all, you may be sharing a lot of jokes, a lot of funny messages and all. So kindly take out 5 minutes from your time and then just put it in various chat WhatsApp groups that you are part of about NDLI. Just share the NDLI app. Go to Play Store or iStore, and there is an option to share the app, NDLI app. So just share it with people of. So Rajesh Sharma ji, aap apna video ko band karke rakhiyega, please. Thank you. So that's my humble request. So if we are about 150 people in this group, even if we share it with 100 people each, we could easily reach 15,000 people in the next 15 minutes or so. So it's all in your hands. So the best service that you can do to the nation at this point in time is share the knowledge. So if you see the value of NDLI, so I humbly request each one of you to share it with everyone. They could be your students, your fellow colleagues, your family members, relatives. So yeah, we have resources for everyone, so you can just share it with them. So with this, I will now resume the presentation. So just let me know whether the screen is visible and my audio is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so thank you. So kindly keep your mic in mute only. Mute your mic, please. Thank you. So now, thank you, fine. So now we are going to look at what is the difference between Google and NDLI with the help of an example. So imagine there is a girl called Payal who is studying in class 8, and she is studying in Hindi medium, and she wants to know about magnetism in the subject of physics. Now Shamik, there is another guy called Shamik who is wanting to pursue his PhD in the topic of magnetism. So now both of them has gone to Google, and they searched for the term called magnetism, and they found 1.89 crore results. Okay, and then they came to NDLI and they searched for the same topic, which is magnetism, and they found 11 lakh resources on this topic. So now what Payal did was, she applied two filters. One is the educational level filter, where she chose 5th to 8th standard, and then the language filter, she applied Hindi. So she got only 8 results. Then what Shamik did was, he wanted only career and technical papers. So he got 219 career and technical papers. So with this, we will see what is the difference between Google and NDLI. So before we see, we need to understand how Google functions. So Google is a brilliant tool. It functions really brilliantly, and it's the best tool that the humankind has ever got, but it has its own limitations. So for example, the moment you put the term called magnetism, it goes around the entire world wide web, and wherever this term called magnetism is there, it pulls the results. In this process, Google can't distinguish whether this resource is coming from an authentic source or an unauthentic source, whether it is an educational content or a non-educational content, whether it is relevant for Shamik or Payal or Vignesh, it can't do. And it can't say whether it's a real information or a fake information. But whereas at NDLI, we actually collaborate with only trusted educational partners, right? And they are all in the educational domain only. So all the content that is there at NDLI are curated educational content. So that's one of the major differences between Google and NDLI. And the second difference is you can actually narrow down the results using various educational filter options. Google also has advanced filter option through which you can further narrow down the results, but they are all generic in nature. They are not educational specific. And the third difference is you can modify the search based on the content type, again related to education. And the fourth difference is national licensing. The government of India has procured national licensing from two educational two publishers. One is World eBook Library, another one is South Asia Archives. And the government of India, on behalf of the Indian citizen, procured a license and gave it to National Digital Library to give access to every Indian citizen at free of cost. So what is the big picture? So the big picture is, already you have this credit transfer and virtual certification scheme under which you can augment about 20 credits from MOOCs. So recently MHRD also gave a notification that you can augment about 20% of your post credit through online mode. That is also there, and sooner or later we may have access to all the educational courses through various platforms like Swayam, Swayam Prabha, Gyan, NDLI. Okay, so if you have access to good connectivity and you have a digital device, you can actually pursue a course, a certificate, diploma or any degree programs by sitting anywhere in the world. So that is a possibility. And now we are going to look at how to operate NDLI Club. So the objective of NDLI Club is two. It has a twin objective. One is, the primary objective it is to promote the culture of reading among the young generations. That's the primary objective. And in this process, we also want to spread the message of NDLI resources to every Indian citizen. So that is the twin objective of NDLI Club. So how do we do this? How do we achieve these objectives? One, you have to first create a NDLI Club members. So at least identify one student from each class and one faculty member from each department, with librarian or a faculty member or NSS coordinator as the ex officio secretary and head of the institution as the ex officio chairman of the club. So you first form the club members and then get the list approved by the head of the institution. And then you need to apply for a NDLI club registration. So there is a separate form. So this is we created on a temporary basis. So we have a Google form which captures the name of the institution, state, district, address, the basic information about the institution, and attach the list of NDLI club members which approved, and then the tentative data for starting the NDLI club in your institution, and then submit. Once you submit, we do a back-end verification of your application and see it meets our criteria. If it meets, then we issue a certificate of registration that is valid for 1 year. And this is how the NDLI certificate of registration looks like. And once you get the certificate of registration, you need to do two activities. It's a two-step activity. First step you need to do is register all the students and faculty members in NDLI within 30 days of receipt. So that is one activity. And the second step is to conduct at least 10 reading or knowledge related activities. So these are the two exercises that you need to do under this club. And now let's look at how to do registration of all the students and faculty members within 30 days. So registration can be done in two formats. One is individual registration, another one is bulk registration. Okay. So Suppose if your friends or relatives or known family members who are interested in registering at NTLA, you can do the individual registration. And especially for higher education institutions, so I would suggest you go for bulk registration, because when UGC or NAC or AICTE come for accreditation or verification, that time they ask for digital resources, digital learning resources you are subscribed to or using. And that time, if you tell them that you are using NDLI, they will ask you to produce the certificate along with the number of students who are registered and number of people who have activated the account. So in that case, suppose if you register your students and faculty members under individual category, you may not be able to show them under the bulk registration. You may not be able to show them the statistics. Suppose if you register your students and faculty members under bulk registration, you'll be able to generate a report about how many people have actually registered and how many people have activated. So that is possible only under bulk registration. So I suggest for the educational institution, higher educational institutions especially, to go for bulk registration. And I will show you how to do bulk registration. So currently I'm conducting an awareness session for all of you. Now what you need to do is, once your NDLA club is formed, you have to conduct an awareness session for your NDLA club members, who are each student from each class, one student from each class, and one faculty member from each department. You conduct an awareness session for them, and they in turn go back and conduct an awareness session for their fellow students and faculty members, right? So once that part is done, then you collect the three details from each student and faculty member. The three details that you need to capture is their personal email ID. I'm repeating personal email ID, because if you give your educational or institutional email ID, that will be active only for 3 or 4 years, depending on the duration they stay in your college or university. After this, you will delete your e their email ID, so they will not have access to accessing these resources after the their college time. So we want to give them lifelong access. So we suggest you collect their personal email ID, their first name and last name. Only these three details are mandatory for bulk registration. So you collect all the details and then send it to our email ID, which is ndl-support@iitkgp.ac.in. Okay, with a copy to my email ID, which is vignesh@ndl.gov.in or vigneshjnu@gmail.com. So once you send it to us, we do a bulk updation of registration of the email IDs. Once we upload, within 48 hours they will get a automated verification email. So that email, there is a URL, you just have to click that URL, and by default your email ID is the username, and password we give a temporary password for that timing. So they have to just re-enter the temporary password and then they can reset their password again, and then they are all set to go. And activation is the most important step. You collect the email ID. Once you do the activation, then only they will be able to accessing the resources. And suppose if your friends or relatives or family members, they want to register as individuals, then they can do by clicking on. So in our homepage, there is on the top, you have a login button. So once you click on that login button, this pop-up window will appear. So here there is a register icon. Just click on this register, then the registration form will open. Fill the basic details and then submit. Then you will get a verification email. Then you can activate your account. So this is how you need to do registration, both bulk and individual registration in our portal. And second step is conducting of various NDLI activities. So some of the activities that you may want to conduct is a lecture series or a quiz competition, or a storytelling session, go fish session, film screening, drawing competition, role play, writing competition, maker space, or debate. And apart from this, you can also come up with your own educational or learning or reading related activities, or inter-college or inter-college interstate activities also can be conducted under NDLI clubs. And so far we have closer to 152 NDLA clubs active across the country, and these are some of the images of our NDLA clubs conducting activities. And we have also developed an incentive mechanism for best performing NDLA club at the district, state, and national level. And also, we are conducting reading Olympiads at the district, state, and national level also. And so, this is my contact details. My email ID is vignesh@ndl.gov.in and vigneshjnu@gmail.com. And my mobile number is 9999 65 44 58. And for bulk registration related queries, you have to contact my colleague Mr. Rajendra Sen. His email ID is ndl-support@iitkgp.ac.in, and his mobile number is 8197 564 857. Okay, so the best way to reach me is by sending an email. Usually, I respond within 24 to 48 hours. In an unavoidable situation, if it's very urgent, you can send me a message, then I will respond to back. And when you are sending an email, kindly mention what is your name, what is your institutional name, what is the purpose that you want to talk. Because a lot of times people just send me, kindly note my number. So there is no email, there is nothing, no name, nothing is mentioned. So how will I save their details? So kindly be very clear of what you want and your contact details also. So now it's time for us to get into the quiz come feedback form. So I'm going to put the URL in the chat window. So kindly don't put any chat message in the next few minutes, because I'm going to enter the feedback form URL. So kindly keep this kindly don't put any message. I'm requesting everyone, kindly don't put any message for the next few minutes. Don't type any message for the next few minutes. And now I'm going to open this form showing how to fill the quiz come feedback form. Don't be in a hurry. I'm going to give you 30 minutes to fill this form. So this is how the feedback form looks like. So here you have to name of your institution in full. Don't write short form of your institution. Write the full name of your institution. Don't make any spelling mistake, because the other day somebody wrote their email ID as their institution name. So suppose if you are an individual, don't write anything there. Just put a dash, then I will make necessary changes. And then write your full name. Don't write only your part of the name and then later come back to me and ask me to change. If you make any mistakes in the name of your institution and then your full name, then the same thing is going to be printed in the certificate. So the certificate will be generated automatically by the system. So if you make any mistakes, then don't come back to me with the correction request, because it's going to be a huge exercise for me to do the entire exercise again and again, because it takes at least 5 to 6 hours for us to verify and then issue the certificate. And then enter the date of the webinar. Don't put your date of birth here. Today's date is 28 May 2020. Don't enter your date of the webinar, and then your designation, your email ID. So be careful with your email ID, because so for example, vigneshjnu@gmail.com. Suppose if I miss at, or if I miss gmail or dot com, then the certificate I will send, it will go to a wrong email ID, or it will not, it will bounce back. So we will not be knowing your email ID, so you will not you will never get your certificate. So you have to be very careful. And then mobile number, and then the quiz question starts. It asks, do you have a login account for NDLI? That means, have you already registered for NDLI? If yes, click here. No, click here. And then the name the various filter options available at NDLI. So I clearly told you what are the various filter options available. You have to at least write some 5 or 6 filter options which you remember. And if you don't remember, kindly go back to the app, refer and then write, or go back to the website and then refer and write. For all the questions, it's open book examination, so you can refer and then write. And then what are the various learning resource types available in NDLI? I also told about it. NDLI content available in how many languages? For people who listen, they will definitely get the answers. List out 5 access options available in NDLI, and how NDLI is different from Google. and how NDLI helps to your learning during this lockdown, COVID-19 lockdown, and you have to write it in 100 words. And then overall feedback about NDLI. And then any suggestion for NDLI to consider, and then the feedback about this online webinar conducted by Dr. Whitney. So this is the quiz come feedback form that we have. You have to score at least 50 marks, 50% marks to be eligible to get the certificate of registration, right? So I got, I hope you got the feedback form now, and don't be in a hurry. You have 30 minutes. So I'm going to close this. After closing, don't come back to me saying that I forgot to filter, I forgot to fill my certificate feedback form, because our system will not allow late entry of responses. So yeah, you have to fill this form by 1:45 p.m. After this, we will close it. Then you will not be able to submit the form. Okay. So this is what I wanted to share it with you. And kindly request everyone to kindly turn off your camera. There is somebody called Associate Professor. Kindly turn off your camera, please. And now, if you have any questions, you can put it in the chat window. I will respond to the chat window. I hope you are able to open the form. So for people who don't know where the form URL is available, if you are using the mobile phone, click on the center of your app and then go to the, you on the top right corner, you will see a round circle with a red dot there. Just click there and then you can scroll down. You can see the URL chat, the Quixcom feedback URL. Just click on that URL, then you will be able to see the Quixcom feedback form. How many of you are able to see the Quixcom feedback form? Kindly put it in the chat message.
Hello, sir.
Kindly put it
Hello?
In the chat window. Don't turn on your mic, please.
I don't have received my feedback form.
Sorry?
I don't have received feedback form, sir.
So I'm telling you, are you using a mobile phone or a desktop or laptop?
No, sir, mobile phone.
Okay, click on the center.
Click on the center.
Yeah.
Okay.
On the top, you will see a round, top right corner, you will see a round with red dot there.
Yes, a chat box.
Yes. So click there and then go down.
Okay.
The log, you will see the URL from me.
No, sir.
Yes, it is there at the bottom.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if you have any questions, kindly put it in the chat window. So if you don't have any questions, then I will end this webinar, and you have time till 1:45 to fill this So Ms. Durga Lakshmi, I have sent you the URL in your chat message. Kindly check. And for people who have submitted
sir, hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yes, tell me.
Sir, I don't have find any. Sir, I don't have find any URL in the chat box.
So if 50 people,
sir.
So I'm going to put it again in the chat. Have you seen where is the chat box?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I have seen.
Okay, So can you see a message now? I've just entered it again. Kindly mute your mic, please. So I've just entered it again. So kindly copy this URL and keep it with you handy, because I'm going to end this meeting now. Dr. E.L. Vanaja, I have just sent you the feedback form to your chat message. Mr. Padmanabhan K, I've sent you the URL. For people who are not able to see the URL, so just send me a chat message. I will reply back individually to your thing. So many people have already started responding. And don't be in a hurry to fill, because even if you make a single mistake, then the answer will be also, the certificate will also be having the same error. We have already got 17 responses so far. For people who have already submitted the responses, you may leave the meeting. Unless and until if you have any specific questions. Vaishali ji, I've just sent you the URL. Shomia, I've just sent you the URL to your chat message. So when we send the e-certificate of registration, that time we will send you the presentation and also the YouTube URL. So we will upload this recording in our YouTube channel. There you can get it. So a lot of people have submitted. So if there are not much questions, so I'm going to end this meeting now, right? I'm going to enter the feedback form URL one last time. So kindly copy it and keep it with you handy. So if you have some internet connection, kindly go to a place where there is good internet connection and then submit. Because if there is no internet connection, then you will not be able to submit the form. But our system will not wait till forever to get the form submitted. So you have to be quick enough to respond. Go to a place where there is good internet connection and then submit it. So you again, if there are not much questions, I'm going to end this webinar. I hope everybody copied and they have started seeing it. So Mr. Praful, I have sent you the URL to your chat message. So kindly check.
Sir, once again, sir, from Jnanamani College, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, final word of thanks. Shall I give the word of thanks, sir? Hello.
Yes, please. Go ahead.
Okay, sir, thank you. So it was a wonderful session. I hope it will be very useful to the faculty and the student for their teaching and learning. Once again, thanks for a good, wonderful session, sir. I invite Mr. Ramesh Babu, head of the Department of English, Jnanamani College of Technology, to deliver the vote of thanks. So, Mr. Ramesh Babu.
I feel it a great honor and privilege to propose the word of thanks on this memorable occasion. Let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's occasion a resounding success. First and foremost, I would like to extend my cordial and genial thanks to our learned and retired speaker, Dr. Vignesh Swarnamogan, Chief Strategic and Outreach Officer, NDLI, IIT Kharagpur, West Bengal. Thank you, sir, for your nice and wonderful presentation during this COVID-19 crisis. Thank you, sir. I'm grateful to extend my thanks to Professor Ramesh, Chief Librarian, Jnanamani College of Technology, for giving a nice welcome address on this memorable occasion. Thank you, sir. I extend my sincere thanks to Dr. Karpakalakshmi for her chief guest introduction address. Thank you, ma'am. My heartfelt thanks to all the participants, professors here from various colleges and organizations, and made this session very lively and informative one. Thank you all. My word of thanks will be complete if I not extend my sincere thanks to the management of Jnanamani Education Institutions for endorsing and guiding us since the initial of the program. I thank the whole management. Last but not the least, I thank all of you for your cooperation in making this function a resounding success. Finally, I leave you all with this inspiring quote: today a reader, tomorrow a leader. Once again, I thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so with this, I'd also like to thank every participant who have attended this webinar, and Nandamani College of Technologies Management, Librarian Ramesh, and all the team that has like put together this webinar. And so we will end this webinar now. So kindly submit the feedback form by 1:45. Once again, I thank everyone for your kind support. Bye.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Nice information.
Okay.